missing out on scoring, and I think this is we're coming up to this is second half now, obviously, with the Raiders going the other way again. Free kick by Richie. Richie has been doing magnificently in the side. Now, normally on any other given day, he would have, you know, lobbed that in, but unfortunately this day it wasn't to be.
Yeah, look, you know, past history between Raiders and Metro Stars, always a tight game. And, you know, I'd say over the past few years, I think Metro Stars have just had the edge just recently. But you only have to look at the Metro Stars lineup to realise how strong they are, and they are going to be a force to be reckoned with this year.
Exactly. And I think this is the goal coming up by Lewis Brain for Metro Stars, coming off the goal kick by Dan Godley, and being able to get past Cody Larkin and getting the second one there for Metro Stars. And we do have to remember that Metros are still without their striker, Scotty Tunbridge, but Francesco Monteroso has been doing very, very well for them. So, and then shortly after, only a couple of minutes later, we had Michael Peroni having an opportunity here to put them 3-0 up, but wasn't to be. Very, very tight, and obviously disappointed there with that shot that he missed. So could have been a 3-0 win for Metro Stars.
Definitely, you know. Again, both teams are doing well in the league, and it shows by their position on the table. And it just shows that, you know, it's great the new format that the FFA or FFSA have come up with the three leagues is working really well.
Yeah, and of course, as you said, yourself and Metro Stars have still got that catch-up round to have, so that's going to be a very interesting match when that gets played.
Definitely, you know, we're looking forward to it. Should be always a close and fiery encounter when the two teams meet, and you know, that's something that we don't shy away from. So we're excited, and we can't wait to play, because when the result goes our way, we should be sitting second.
Oh, that would be very exciting for the Red Devils. So let's have a look at the footage from your match, and it was another very, very exciting match in the Super League. I have to say, the weather was kinder this week, but I thought the pitch condition, and you're going to see it throughout these highlights, where players were, their feet were giving way from, you know, underneath them with this pitch. What was it like to play on?
Yeah, it was it was a bit soggy in patches, and it was firm in other patches, which made it very, very tough, because I guess you couldn't wear your screw-ins, but the moulds in certain areas made it difficult, because you just kept slipping over. But overall, you know, as I said to you, I've played on worse pitches than that, and nothing's happened.
Now, of course, within the second minute, you got Catanzaro, you're showing off his skills there, some beautiful ball work, and just unbelievable. He is a quality player, isn't he?
He's a delightful player to watch, and he's fantastic to have in your team. You know, he's surprises you. He's unpredictable with his skill, and you know, as you could see there.
And of course, Torre getting that goal there, which was fairly early in the match, and of course putting you one up. Lovely. He's just brilliant. The opportunities that he creates from basically nothing is just a pleasure to watch.
Definitely, he's a breath of fresh air, you could say. Mm. He's come into this team, and he is absolutely lightning fast, and he causes a lot of people problems. I'm rapt that he's on my team, and we're not chasing him around. So, yeah, he's very good.
Definitely. Now, of course, I mean, Adelaide Blue Eagles, you force them to make a lot of errors just by the possession, the way that you pass the ball around. And also another thing is that there was a lot of attention to yourself, Torre, and Catanzaro by your opposition.
Yeah, it was a very physical game. You know, it's something, as we said, it's a derby match, and you know, we were under the impression it was going to be like that, and we just tried to keep our heads. One thing we didn't want to do was get overawed and start kicking back. Just play our game, play to the instructions set by Rocky Aloisi, and we did.
Now, of course, in this passage of play, we see some absolutely crunching tackles. This is, just shows the desperation of both sides, and obviously Blue Eagles to try and get that goal back.
Yeah, definitely. As when it gets to a derby match, there's no hold bars. You know, I think overall the referee had a fantastic game.
He did.
I think there were a few occasions where quite possibly he could have pulled out a yellow card and tried to calm things down, but you know, his cards did stay in his pocket, and as I said, Paul had a great game.
Definitely. Now, coming up is something that we don't quite often see, and that is Dominic Signorello scoring. This was magnificent, the way he positioned himself and was able to finish off.
I think, and a lot of people don't see what Catanzaro did there, but his first touch and his little through ball, he's an amazing player. And, you know, unfortunately, as we'll see later, he got injured in the match. Mm. And will take no further part for us this season. Mm. But, you know, the little through balls that he does, he's an amazing player.
Definitely. Now, from this goal kick, you can see the sort of Ali Tori manufacturing some beautiful work. Just watch him. He's just brilliant to watch.
He is. And he's lining. Once he's in front of you, you're going to find it very hard to catch him. And, you know, we're working on his finishing at the moment to try and get him a little bit better. But he is a brilliant player to watch.
Definitely. And now, again, some more close checking here. Dominic Signorello copying a bit of a crunching by Sarante Perizos.
Yes. Look, Sarante's had a bit of blues with certain players in our team before, and I think he had a good game as well. Sarante kept his head, obviously went in for a few challenges, but that's to expect. We're all going to do that in a derby match.
Now, here was an opportunity for Blue Eagles to equalise, obviously from the corner, but an awkward bounce, and Les was able to pick it up cleanly.
Yeah, Les has been great for our team. Not that Eddie Scousey wasn't fantastic for us last year and during the pre-season. So we're very lucky to have the two of them in the team. And, yeah, they're doing very well.
Now, there we could see some brilliance by Simon. Yeah. A beautiful
back heel.
Yeah, absolutely beautiful. I mean, this is the sort of, you know, quality player you're coming up against time and time again. And that makes your midfield very, very strong.
It does. And, you know, you can't say enough about him. It's such a tragedy what's happened to him, and you know, all we can do is wish him a speedy recovery so that not only us but the opposition fans can watch him play.
Definitely. Now, here's another chance for Blue Eagles, but a great clearance by Stanko Zilic on the line there, so very well done there.
Yeah, it certainly wasn't one-way traffic for the entire match, and Blue Eagles, to their credit, once they went 2-0 down, turned the screw a little bit and put us on the back foot. But, you know, we always knew it was going to be tough, and we just held out.
Now, end of the first half, you've got a bit of argy-bargy going on here.
Yeah, the whistle went, and one of their players just smacked the ball straight into Michael Minichiello, and he didn't enjoy that, and I don't blame him. And, you know, once again, everyone's in there. I tried to calm a few players down and keep them away, because the last thing we needed was a red card.
Yeah, definitely. And very, as you said, a very good display by the referees and lines people, assistant referees. That I've seen some great refereeing this week, I have to say. Magnificent. Now, this one here, this is your goal coming up. Absolutely. Well, opportunistic, because you were there at the right place, right time, and you put yourself into that position.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I couldn't believe my luck when the ball fell to me inside the 6-yard box. So, but it's one thing I've tried to do my whole career, and that's get inside the box and always follow up on any shots that have happened, and it paid off this time.
Now, you're obviously very happy there. Now, what were you thinking at that time? Is it basically capping off your 350th with a goal?
It was a lot of relief. As I said to you before, I put a lot of pressure on myself to not only play well but to try and score a goal, and I knew that making it 3-0 really, really you know, wrapped up the game for us, because I couldn't see the way we were playing that we were going to concede three goals. So it was very important.
Now, look, Blue Eagles were consistently looking for Sarante up front, but Les covered every single time that they did kick the ball long to find him.
Yep.
And he was able to basically, you know, neutralise Sarante's leads.
Yeah, definitely. Les is a big boy, and, you know, anything that's high in the box, he'll come and clean up.
Now, of course, we see you copying a nasty one, which we see your wounds, your black eye for that, and... something not, you don't want to be getting stuff like that during a game, do you?
No, you don't. I mean, I know Diego Pellegrini pretty well, and I know that he didn't mean it. My head was low to the ground. I tried to flick on a header, and he's gone to clear the ball from behind. Just unfortunate. I don't believe my head looks like a soccer ball, but people might tell me different.
Now, coming up in this bit of play, you almost get your second when Blue Eagles get dispossessed, comes on the break.